I was talking about career guidance to 9th and 10th standard students of a particular school. They had a very long and narrow hall, and the children were made to all sit on the ground. At one point, I said, just to stir them up, because there were about 150 children, you know, I thought just going on lecturing and the one sitting behind would hardly be able to see me or hear me properly. So instead of a lecture, let me just stimulate their mind. I said, okay, we all have some good qualities in us. You know, I want you to identify your good qualities and then match them to what career. If I am good at speaking, maybe I can make a good lawyer or teacher or politician or administrator or something. If I am good in concentration or in number, then maybe I can become a chartered accountant or a, you know, a software programmer or something. So that way, if I know what are my basic qualities, what I am good at, I can start matching it to my which career would suit me most. So I said, would any one of you like to come and tell one good quality of yours which makes you absolutely unique, which you feel is not there in most of the others, and you know, you have some very unique quality, would you like to say? As it usually happens, because children are always trained, no? Keep your mouth shut and listen to the teacher, don't open your mouth. So if you say something, you may get scolded, but best thing to do is to shut up and keep quiet. 150 children, nobody is getting up. Suddenly, at the end, I saw one tiny little fellow come walking. I said, this fellow can't be from this group, maybe he's come from outside. But what is he doing in this hall? Anyway, he came pretty briskly. There was a stage, he came running up the steps. I thought maybe the principal has sent some message or something through him. So I turned to him and I said, yes, what do you want? He said, I want the mic. I said, okay, maybe he has to make some announcement or something of that sort. I gave the mic to him. He took the mic and he said, I want to challenge everyone in the hall, all the 9th and 10th standard students sitting over here, that nobody is as short as me and nobody can be as short as me, because you cannot grow shorter. That is my USP. He gave the mic back and walked off. Now normally, if you are shorter than your classmates, what happens? Self-esteem is low, they tease you, they go on, you know, pushing you back, they don't allow you to play games, and everywhere you feel miserable, see, because of my height, what can I do, God made me like this, it's not my fault, why did God make me like this, why should I be so short, why can't I have been like this, see, I'm not capable of anything and all that. Now here is this fellow who comes and tells 150 colleagues, I challenge you that nobody can be as short as me and nobody can become short also in future. So I am unique. Now after that, can they tease him? That's it. He took that opportunity and he turned the tables back on all of them. That's why I said that this example has really remained deep in my mind. I want all of us to understand that we can be our best friends, we can be our worst enemies. As I told you, because I am with me 24/7 and I am with me for the rest of my life. Now I have to choose, and I cannot be perfect in everything. I cannot be the tallest or shortest or fattest or thinnest or whatever, or the most educated or the richest or this or that or healthiest or whatever it is. Everybody has some gradations. And who sets benchmark for whom? Why should anybody else in the world set benchmarks for me? Supposing I am not good in academics, I have capabilities in something else. But if I am, as the topic of today mentions, if I learn how to be nice to myself, number one, I can adapt to whatever shortcomings I have. Where even if somebody tries to be bad to me, somebody tries to tease me, I can turn the tables on them and I can maintain my esteem. Secondly, once I have accepted my shortcomings, I can move on and spend more time and energy exploiting the areas in which I am good. Otherwise, I get so caught up in the areas where I am incapable or lesser capable than others, that my focus goes entirely on that, and then I start getting caught up in a vicious cycle.